You know, now that the weather is pretty good, it stopped raining after a few days, and today, bright sunshine. So I decided that I think it's time for me to do one of the more important things that I always neglect, which is to wash my bike, right? And you know, it's basically part of the maintenance cycle that you need to do. And the state of my bike is pretty bad. So I'm gonna head off to a place that's nearby, about 7 minutes. Let's go and take a look and see what it's all about and how they go ahead and put my bike back to where it used to be. I'm now here on my bike and I'm gonna head off to this place called Engloss. When I first came out, in fact the sun is still out, but here's the pain, you know. I'm planning to have it washed and polished, and what happens? The dark clouds are coming and it's going to rain. Man, that sucks. The reason for this video is basically about basic maintenance. And when I say basic maintenance, I think the most important thing is washing your bike and taking care of it, as you should. Besides, you know, changing oils and checking the brakes and stuff like that, and doing the regular servicing that you need to do. I think beyond that, it's important that we keep the bike clean, take off the rusty bits, because at the end of the day, it's all about making sure that everything is in prime condition. By cleaning the bike, it will mean that you would be able to see bits that are not working, wires that may have been crossed or cut off or what have you, leakages, which I think is really, really important to be able to see if there's any leakage, because if it's dirty, chances are if it's a minor leak, you won't be able to see anything. Woe is me, it's suddenly cloudy. Man, that's just bad luck. Well, hopefully it just lasts for an hour. It doesn't look like a big one. And by the time they are done, because it doesn't mean that I'm going there, and even though I have a kind of an appointment, it doesn't mean that, you know, they're going to start straight away and get it done. It probably takes an hour or so to get it done, especially in the state my bike is in. It's probably going to be worse. So, yeah. So what they're going to do is they're going to wash the bike, obviously. And then they're going to put some good chemicals to make sure that everything is taken off. And then after which, they would dry it off and then start the polish process. Hopefully they'll be able to take off some of the rusty bits off my spokes and everything else. And the one thing I like about this company is that they have really good chemicals. They actually went for courses and stuff, which later I'll see if I can show it to you. And be able to ensure that they get it done the right way. So we're basically almost there. In fact, I'm already there, getting into the building. I believe it's a third or fourth floor, I can't really remember. But I'm going to turn off here. All right, so I passed the gantry, and I'm going up the car park. So in a sense, it's good that it's a covered car park. So even if it rains, all that good work is not going to waste. It's a multi-story car park, obviously. This is the first floor. Second floor. Wow, it's really going to rain. That's woe is me. All right, so here we are. At this place. And interesting that they have seating. Okay, so I'm gonna just ride in into the bay here. And wow, they have a lot of cars here. Right, so guys, I'll see you in a bit.
Right, folks, I'm here at the place called Engloss, as you can see. Basically, this is on the third floor, or fourth floor, based on the sign I just saw over there. And these guys do a really good job. They not only wash, they put chemicals on it to make sure that all the dirt is taken off. I've been told that I would probably need to do some grinding on the spokes to be able to take off the thing, and it takes a couple of hours. I'm not sure if I'm prepared to spend that kind of time. I probably might come back the next day to have it done. But this is the place to be. Englok is the name of the place. This is called the Proxima building. And I'll do a couple of shots of the interior. I did already of some of the process that they're doing. I'll try to do some more shots of the process, so they give you my take on it just after this.
I just had a look at my bike and they're just almost done. I probably have to leave the spokes for another time because it's going to take a little bit more time. But they really did a very excellent job. Later on I'll put some pictures and of everything and a little video to show the condition after. As you saw in the beginning, I showed how bad it was and then how it's going to look like after. But anyway, it's good again, a little recap, that you should do basic maintenance, and basic maintenance means literally having the bike wash, clear the contaminants, take off the rust, clean off all the dirt and everything else, so that you'll be able to see if there's any damage to the bike and everything else. So go ahead, do that, whether you're doing it on your own or in my case going to a professional to get it done. It's good that you do basic maintenance. Anyway, if you haven't yet, please do hit the like button. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And of course, don't forget to hit the notification bell to let you know when my next video is out. Thank you very much. I'm Fletch, and you have safe rides.